In My Absolute Darling, I'm trying to write the story of Turtle Alveston, who's a young woman who is fighting for her own soul. Her father is very controlling and abusive, and as each step towards independence provokes retaliation and controlling behavior, Turtle finds herself having to turn against the person who means most to her in the world. And so it's a story of, I wanted to write a story of resistance, of someone fighting to be the right person, to be a good person. I felt that the most serious thing, like the full attention of the novel had to be on Turtle, on Turtle's fight for her own soul and the things that she thought and believed. Everything else mattered less. So that was my primary focus. That was what I was always looking for. That was what I was always writing for. I mean, aren't we all sort of ambiguous in that sense? Like, you're saying she's trying to be independent and she's a victim, but those are sometimes the same thing, you know? We are all subject to violence. She's no different from any other. Look, like all protagonists in fiction are fighting to find their way and are sometimes lost. And that's what she is. She's no different from any other character. Her circumstances, maybe we understand to be shameful, but that's not her fault. And that maybe doesn't actually have very much to do with the reality of her life. Like, she hasn't done anything shameful. I think that when you are writing fiction about someone you are not, someone different from you, you're always writing across a divide of privilege, you're writing across the table of gender, and it can be blinding. And I think what I tried to do is to bring my own vantage point. I thought that even looking across the table of gender, I had seen things that were important. I had seen things and I understood things to be true, and I wanted to write those as I had seen them. Fiction becomes the project of trying to see other people clearly, to believe deeply in the existence of other people. And I tried to do that, and I take great comfort that I'm not the only writer doing this, right? Like, what I get wrong, other writers will get right. And so I didn't have to say everything, I only had to say a little bit, and so I tried to say the things I knew to be true. Martin is a person in pain, trying to be more than his wounds, right? And because he's in pain, like when we are in very great pain, we can't always think about other people or see people clearly. All we see is ourselves, right? And so there are moments when he's able to love his daughter, and there are moments when he can think only about himself. And I think when you are the child of such a person, you hold out hope. You're always hoping that your parent will do more, will be strong, will win that fight. And so Turtle understands her father with a great deal of love, but not everyone wins that fight. Not everyone is in the end more than their wounds. But the word ambiguous, I want to resist. Ambiguous applies that there's nothing necessarily true, like ambivalent, divided in themselves, but ambiguous, no, what he does is wrong. It's not ambiguous. We shouldn't hurt people. No matter if we were hurt ourselves, we shouldn't hurt other people. That's wrong. And you try and write that with clarity and understanding and nuance. And sometimes, because you write with understanding, people think that you feel multiple ways about it. But you don't. I think you shouldn't hurt children. And you try and show the awfulness of violence to get that point across, that hurting children is wrong, that the legacy of it is terrible, that what is at stake is far greater than we sometimes imagine.